Welcome to News at Noon. I'm Chris Nelson. A Detroit police officer who also runs a boot camp for troubled teens is facing criminal sexual conduct charges for incidents that allegedly occurred at his Farmington Hills home. John Turk has more on this story. John, what can you tell us?
Well, according to the Oakland County Prosecutor's Office, 43-year-old Jeffrey Townsend has been charged with four counts of third-degree criminal sexual conduct and one criminal sexual assault charge. He faces up to 15 years in prison if convicted. Townsend is suspected of sexually assaulting a 15-year-old he met at the boot camp he founded called Reality Check Detroit, and is accused of incidents that occurred at his Farmington Hills home between October 2010 and August 2012. The officer's biography on his camp's website, realitycheckdetroit.org, elaborates on several very personal aspects of the 43-year-old's life. A homeless stretch, a near-death run-in with a drug dealer, and an injury from a car crash are all recounted as life experiences that fueled Townsend's desire to help his community's youth avoid the hardships he had to endure. Some supporters of Townsend wrote on Reality Check Detroit's Facebook page saying, quote, "Yes, I'm praying for him to get through this, and he has helped me and my son through some times, and I do thank him for all he's done." The Detroit Police Department released a statement Thursday saying they will fully participate as the case moves forward. This morning, Judge Marla Parker of Farmington Hills took Townsend's passport and continued his bond of $25,000. He's expected again in court April 19th.
All right. Thank you, John. And a new emergency manager law takes place today in Michigan. Reporter Charlie Crum is here to discuss this new law and other hot political topics. Charlie, take it away.
A federal judge has dismissed a lawsuit against the Oakland County Prosecutor, Sheriff, and the Michigan State Police that alleged they withheld information in the Oakland County child killer case from the 1970s. The suit was filed by Deborah Jarvis of Petoskey, whose 10-year-old daughter, Christine Mihelich of Berkeley, was among four children killed between February 1976 and March 1977. U.S. District Judge Denise Page Hood ruled the lawsuit lacked merit. In Macomb County, a group called the Committee to Ban Fracking is launching a petition drive in Warren. It wants a ballot question on the November 14th election ballot to ban hydraulic fracturing in Michigan. That's a controversial process for extracting oil and natural gas from the ground. That group needs to gather 258,000 valid signatures within 6 months in order to put the question on the November 2014 ballot. A new law giving emergency managers more power takes effect today, a day after Michigan's controversial right-to-work law took effect, and opponents continue to promise that they'll challenge both into the future.
Okay, thank you, Charlie. And spring break is often known for its excessive partying. However, the Clarkston Coalition for Youth has been organizing family-friendly spring break alternative events. The event dates and times can be found on theoaklandpress.com.
This is our second year, and last year we had copied a program from another local community, and we wanted to make sure that families that were staying in town for spring break had a lot of opportunities to stay here, have fun, do a community service project, perhaps dine out, and maybe get a discount. So we worked really hard with all the local businesses to put this program together. So check it out on our Facebook and our website, clarkstonyouth.org, or like us on Facebook, and we're the Clarkston Coalition for Youth.
A large expansion is in the works for a Kroger store in Commerce that will make it the largest Kroger store in all of Michigan. Marissa Weber and Alex Hancock report in this special to News at Noon.
I'm Marissa Weber reporting live in Commerce, Michigan at the intersection of Commerce Road and Union Lake. This Kroger is going to expand to be the largest one in Michigan.
I think it'll be positive, an expansion of jobs and opportunities for those of us who are already employed here. This is a high traffic area with very few bits of competition. There's not a lot of other options right now, so an expansion of Kroger's would mean more variety for the locals here and more job opportunities as well.
Now, they will be adding a coffee shop area as well as a dining room area for all those people that like to grab coffee and maybe have a little lunch before going grocery shopping. They will also be adding a floral department and a drive-through pharmacy for all those people who do not like to get out of their car either on a very cold day or a very hot day.
On to college basketball, sports columnist Pat Caputo shares his thoughts on the competition that U of M and MSU face in tonight's NCAA tournament.
Look, it's very difficult to predict what's going to happen with Michigan and Michigan State in the Sweet 16 of the NCAA tournament. Impossible. All right, look at how this tournament's gone. Who would have thought, you know, Florida Gulf Coast would get to the Sweet 16? Look at all the different upsets that have happened. Anything can happen. But these are big-time programs that both schools are playing. Kansas is a very, very, very good team. It's been there. You know, Bill Self has been there many times. I think Michigan's going to have their hands full. But this is Trey Burke's time. If he wants to make an impact, if he wants to get noticed by the NBA, if he really, really wants to be the best player in the country and carry Michigan to greatness and be all that Trey Burke can be, this is his day. That's not easy. And we'll see whether he's able to do that. He's a great player nonetheless. But he's got a certain character, certain heart. He may be able to carry Michigan in a certain way against Kansas. As for Michigan State, look, Tom Izzo has struggled against the ACC powerhouse teams. He's beaten Duke a couple times, but Duke's beaten him a lot more than on the other hand. Same with North Carolina when they've been really good. They've tended to beat the Spartans in these big games. We'll see if Izzo can change that.
And that's our newscast for today. Join us again on Monday at theoaklandpress.com. I'm Chris Nelson for News at Noon. Have a great Easter weekend.